Hello, it's James here. Welcome to my Autodesk Maya tutorial. Let's create our squash controller in Autodesk Maya. First, select the mesh. Go to deform, nonlinear, and select squash. Go to the squash component. Practically, we have our squash and stretch already. But we still need to configure it. Let's set our low bound to 0. If it looks weird now, it's because the position of the squash handler to the world vector 3. Select our squash handler and set the translate Y to 0. So it's right on the ground now. Now if we try again, it will squash on the ground. Still look weird on the stretch though. Set the height bound to 1.5. It's different for each model. Works on this one. Now our squash and stretch should be working as intended. Let's work on the controller. Add an URBS circle, adjust the size and freeze it so it has uniform scale. Put it into a group so it works as its offset factor 3 for rigging purpose. Name it accordingly. Put the squash handler into the group. Now go to the squash component and right click on the factor attributes and select set as driven key. Select the controller and load its driver. Lock to translate Y. Set the translate Y of the controller as 0 and the factor value as 0 and key. Now, set the translate Y of the controller as 1.5 and the factor value as 1. If you follow the setup, the stretch should have maxed at 1.5, so it's like 1 from the factor multiplied by 1.5. And if the max is 2, it will like 1 from the factor multiplied by 2. But for now, we'll work with 1.5. Key it, and it should work like this. One last thing, let's pattern the squash offset to the root controller. And now it will follow the route and we are done. If you like this video, leave a like, subscribe, and don't forget to ring the bell so you won't miss any of my future tutorials. Anyway, thank you for watching. This is James and I am out. See you next time. Bye.